I think I want Proverbs 14 and 11. We'll see. 11 and 24. That's what I want. I like that one, though. The tabernacle of the upright shall flourish. It's Proverbs 11, 24. All right. He said, he that scattered, there's that scattered and yet increase. And there's that withhold more than meat and but it tend to poverty. Right? And so, and the liver soul shall be made fat, and he that water shall be watered also himself. He that withhold corn, the people shall curse him, but blessing shall be upon the head of him that sell it. Right? Now, this whole thing here dealing with this supernatural law, sowing and reaping, I was looking at something here earlier. If you go to 1 Kings real quick. First Kings 17. You know, in these last days, or last of the last days, you know, one of the deceptions of the devil to let people to think that there's a lot of time left. And so they live life on the edge. That's very dangerous right now. That's very dangerous to live life on the edge right now. Because there's a lot of, the enemy has set a curse out there. Amen. And it's a trap. I'm telling you, it's very important. And if you go to verse 8, 1 Kings 17, verse 8. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, get thee, arise and get thee to Zarephath, which belongs to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he arose and went to Zarephath. When he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there, gathering the sticks. He called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink it. And as he was going to fetch it, he called her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand. And she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake but a handful of meal in a barrel and a little oil in a cruse. Behold, I'm gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son that we may eat it and die. So we see here the inventory she had. Now, why would God send that person to her and ask to do that? What God is doing, this supernatural law that lost sowing and reaping to get her needs met. Now, if you look at this, if you go on down, the reason why she spoke of death, because she saw fear. Yeah. And fear is a strange thing, because when a person act, fear didn't just come right then. Yeah. It manifested, but it didn't just come. It had to been settled in her mind, thinking about it. And so Elijah basically rebuked that fear. Now watch this. If you go to the next scripture here, this is how the believer live by faith. By the seed they sow. Yeah. Thus said the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail until the day of the Lord send rain upon the earth. Verse 15. No, I want verse 16. And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word. According to the word. Because if it's hung on the word, it's good is done. Amen. Right, it's time to give. I don't want to stay on this stuff. Hey, Ray, can you get my eyeglass case out there? Now, It go right. All right. Let me pray over that so I can get to work here, because I got to really put some stuff in play here tonight. Father, release an anointing over that seed. We speak the blessing over that is multiplied back to the giver. We thank you for the 1,000 times more harvest, and we rebuke the devourer that he cannot touch this harvest or destroy the seed. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you got your Bible. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 4 and Hebrews 11. Father, come to you in Jesus' name. We thank you for the anointing. We thank you for revelation knowledge. We thank you that revelation will flow freely, unhindered, unchecked by any outside satanic force, and we bind the wicked one. And I release an anointing in this place that you're my spirit, soul, and body, till you think through my mind, see through my eyes, hear through my ears, and speak through my mouth, that your word be spoken in boldness and accuracy. We thank you for the greater one lives on inside of us, and I release angels in this place according to Psalms 103:20. Excel in strength and hearken to the voice of the word. And activate the ministry angels in this place in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Faith to manifest the unseen. 2 Corinthians 4:18. It said, "Why we look not at the things which are seen, but the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen is temporal, but the things which is not seen is eternal." Now, we go to Hebrews 11:3, and I want that first in the King James, then the TPT. I want you to see something here. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. You put that in the TPT. Faith empower us to see that the universe were created and beautifully coordinated by the power of God's words. He spoke, and the invisible realm gave birth to all that is seen, to all that is seen. So God deals with the believer only within the framework of his word. He don't go outside his word. Psalms 138:2 in the Amplified, if you put that up real quick. "I will worship towards the holy temple and praise thy name for love and for thy love and kindness and for thy truth, for you have magnified your word above all your what? Name." God limited himself to deal with man only with the framework of his word. All right? And so with that being in mind, it amazed me sometime how believers can be ignorant, thinking that God will accept anything. Anything. Anything that is inconsistent with the word of God, God can't back it. He can't back it. He can't back error. He can't back philosophy. He only back his word. All right? Now, God's power can only be released within the scope of the word. Go to Proverbs 4:18. I'm just kind of talking a little bit here, but I'm going to get to it. It said, "But the path of the just is as the shining light, and that shineth more and more into the perfect day." Path here is where we begin to get pattern. That's a pattern. All right? It's a pattern to rise at a superior level of light, which is revelation of the word. That's a pattern God set in place. And so, and what happened a lot of time, God want us to increase. Psalms 115, and this is within the scope of the word now. Let's go there real quick. Everything I'm telling you is within that word. All right? Psalm 115, verse 14. "The Lord shall increase you," what? "More and more, you and your children." So we see within the framework of the word, God said he shall increase us more and more. All right? Now, the reason why people don't experience a lot of increase, or I call it manifestation, is because there is structure as far as God dealing with man. a structure. He put something, he put a pattern in place. And there is mysteries that God put in the earth, in the kingdom, that if you don't understand certain mysteries and operate on them, you won't see increase. Now, let's go back to Hebrews 11 and 3. Let's get going here. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were what? Framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible or do appear. Now, 2 Corinthians 4:18, while we look not at the things which are what? Seen, but the things which is what? Not seen. For the things which are seen is temporal, but the things which is not seen is eternal. Now, this here, the word frame here mean that these things had material expression. Let me explain this. The things that are seen are only seen because there's a spiritual parallel to it. The seen realm is connected to the unseen. But the seen realm is a slave or a child to the unseen. So when a person tries to make changes in the earth where they have problems and they try and make it at the level of the seen, they already lost. They already lost. Any adjustments that you make to make changes in your life have to be from the unseen. It's the real realm of reality. Matter of fact, the unseen realm is the only realm of reality. The seen realm is just the realm of manifestation. Glory to God. That's what I wanted to get to. Watch this. Let me get to it. Seeing realm is the physical realm, three-dimensional realm. This is what you can see. It's the things in this earth. The physical realm is not the real realm of reality. The physical realm is where realities are manifested. Amen. Manifested from where? The unseen. Because the unseen realm is the realm of creation. Ha, ha, ha. Y'all looking at, watch this. Increase don't come from the earth. Amen. So, a lot of people hustling and trying to do stuff to get increase in the earth, and they wonder why they get pennies, because it don't come from the earth. It don't generate it.
Amen.
It is a commodity in the unseen realm. It just manifests in the earth. That's all it is. And Lord, can I just take it somewhere? Increase is spiritual. When you see it in the earth, it just manifests it. That's all in manifestation. 1 Corinthians 3, verse 6. If you put that up, watch this. I have planted, this Paul, Apollos have what? Water it. But who give the increase?
God
is a what? Spirit. It's spiritual. Now, go to verse 7 real quick. All right. So then neither is he that planted anything, neither he that watered, but God is the one that give the increase. Because increase is spiritual.
Amen.
You get increase before you get increase.
Amen.
If you don't receive increase from the unseen, it won't manifest.
Amen.
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 Let me give you that example then. John 6, verse 5. No. Matthew 14. Matthew 14. What I'm doing, I'm trying to get you to lose faith in the seen realm. Because Sunday, I'm going to teach you how to pull from it. Now, watch this. How to change your reality. If you're trying to change your reality on the same platform the reality is at, folks, it's not going to change. Matthew 14, and I want you to put verse 15. Watch this. And when it was evening, his disciple came to him saying, this is a what?
Desert
place. The time is now past. Send a multitude away. They may go into the village and buy themselves some food. 5,000 people now. 5,000 people. But Jesus said unto them, they need not depart. You give them something to eat. Watch what they say, because they're looking at something here. They say unto him, we have what? Five loaves and two what? Fish. All right. All right. Let's just go back. Five loaves and two fishes. The unseen realm is the realm of creation. It's parallel. So, man, I'm trying not to go back to something I'm gonna probably go to. So if you see something in the earth, in the seen realm, mm-hmm. that's a spiritual root to it. Yeah. That it came from the unseen. All right. Now I'm going to show you that in a minute. Five loaves and two fishes. Yes. Watch this. Verse 18. He said, bring it hither to me. Now, when Jesus said, you give them something to eat, increase, he already had received increase. Because he won't prepare to do something that he didn't receive. Now, this is faith here now, because faith don't look at the seen realm and try and make something happen. It draws off the unseen. Watch this. Bring them hither to me. Verse 19. He commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass, took the five loaves and two fishes, looking up where? To heaven. Picture unseen, bless, break, and gave. Now, that's another scripture that said he gave thanks. Watch this. Gave the loaves to his disciples and the disciples to the multitude. Now, in this unseen realm is everything that pertains to life and godliness, according to 1 Peter. If that's the case, food can be made or transferred from the unseen realm. Yeah. Watch this, verse 20. They did all what? Eat. And were filled, and they took up a fragments what? 12 baskets. Where did food come from then? Don't give me the religion. Just think about it. It didn't come from a place you can see. Because you don't see it, don't mean it's not real. Amen. Genesis 1:26. Let's look at that. He said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. What is God's image then? John 4:24. He's a spirit. Can you see a spirit?
No.
So he said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the fowl of the air. Now, just think about it. He made man, he created man's spirit. He drew man's spirit out of himself.
Yeah, that's right.
All right? In his image. Yes. He formed a body later.
That's right.
The body will make you illegal in the seen realm.
That's right.
Because you can see the body.
That's right.
But you can't see the spirit.
That's right.
And your body, in order for it to stay living, the spirit, what you can't see, got to stay in it.
Amen.
So your spirit can live without your body, but your body cannot live without your spirit.
Amen.
Now, you can't see your spirit, but it's there. So now, if you have arms, physical arms you can see, you also have spiritual arms.
Amen.
If you have natural eyes, you got spiritual eyes. I'll show it to you. I'm trying to get you to see something here. All right. Give me a second. I got notes. Lord, and I want you to see this. I think it's Luke. Give me 1 second. Yep. Luke 16, verse 19. That's what I want you to see. Everything have a visible expression that came from this unseen. We call it the spirit realm. What you see, what you can't see, it have a visible expression. You have a visible expression. Watch that. There was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen, fared sumptuously every day. Watch this. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at the gate full of sores, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man died also and was buried. Wait. The rich man was died and he what? Was
buried.
Watch this. In hell, he lift up his what?
Eyes.
I thought he was buried, though. I thought he was buried. But he got eyes.
Yes.
Wait. Being in torment, whoa, he can feel it? And he see Abraham afar off. Let's keep looking at this. Both of their bodies no longer exist. All right. But he still had eyes in verse 24. Watch this. And he cried. Wait, he can talk. He still have a mouth. Your natural eyes is not superior. Your spiritual eyes is.
Amen.
That's what Satan went after in the garden.
Yes.
Amen. That's right.
They were no longer ruled by their spiritual eyes. Their natural intellect took over. Their natural eyes took over and they were guided by that. Watch this. He said, send Lazarus, still trying to give orders, that he may dip the tip of his what? So he got fingers. His spirit got fingers. And cool my tongue. Wait, he got a spirit, he got a tongue. You know your tongue's spiritual because he said the power of life and death is in it. He's not talking about your organ tongue. Your spiritual tongue. Now, which one exists forever? Which body? Your spirit body or your natural body?
Spirit.
Because your spiritual body was with God. Oh, Lord Jesus. Jeremiah knew you before you was in the womb. Wait, how is that? How is that? So now all of God's power have been downloaded inside my spirit. So trying to make changes in the natural through the intellect, which most people try, and they get into frustration, you already lost from the beginning. You have to go into the realm of the unseen, the realm of correction, the realm of alignment. And whatever you correct in the unseen will manifest itself in the seen. I'm going to show you how to do that on Sunday. But I just want to stay with this because the word here, frame, I want to go back to Hebrews 11 and 3 again. The only reason why things are seen because they have a spiritual parallel of something from the unseen. The only reason why, because they have a spiritual parallel from the unseen. Now, let's look at this here. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, right? It was framed by what? The word of God. So that the things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. So when there's something going on in your life, it ain't your ball. If you're trying to correct that, you already unlocked. You got to go into that realm of correction to deal with the spiritual. Well, why they don't work? The reason why I showed you before in Proverbs 4:18 is because you are void of a level of light, a revelation that you need to make the correction. The path, the pattern of the just is as the shining what? Light that shine more and more into the perfect day. So the only way to rise is to increase revelation, light, to increase knowledge. All right? Now, let's look at this. Glory to God. If you deal with issues from a natural standpoint, if you go to Proverbs 16:25 in the TPT, you'll find yourself losing battles left and right. Have nothing to do with God. Before every person, there's a what? Path that seemed like the right one to take. But it leads straight to hell. So this is when you're doing it on a sensual level, on a natural level, where the word is not first place. And here goes, there are two things that, you know, I want to talk about being spiritual. So if you're looking at things from a natural standpoint, you will get on a path and in the natural, and you don't realize it, you don't watch it, you'll be on the wrong path for 5 years. And there may not be a correction in the natural. But in the realm of the spirit, there's a correction you can make. There's correction. Because the more light you get, the more revelation you get in the word. Are y'all with me? I know I'm trying to take it slow, but the more revelation, insight you get in the word, the more you'll be able to correct things in the unseen. You can't rise as high as the revelation you have, because in this realm of creation, if you go to John 1:1, in the beginning was what? The Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word what? Was God. Now, I want you to see this, because this is what I want to hone into right here. Verse 3. All things were made by him. Now, let's look at this. All things were made by him. It didn't say all natural things. It didn't say all natural things. All right? Even in the spirit realm, the word is supreme. All things were made by him. Watch this. Without him, not anything made that was what? Made. There's everything you see. There is a spiritual parallel to it. It came from the spirit. It don't come from the natural to the spirit. That's the wrong direction. It came. So what happened? Satan is not a creator. That's why he contaminates those things in the seen realm. He had to wait till his creator and manifest it. Remember in the garden, in the wilderness, when Jesus was in Luke 4, he said, Luke 4, when you talk about the stone, turn it to bread. You know why he said that? He couldn't do it. Because he can't create. You be the son of God, do this. He couldn't do it because he can't create. You and I have the nature of God.
Amen.
And so what we have to do is switch our eyes. Switch it back to what God said. When I mean switch the eyes, Adam and Eve, their eyes switch once they fail. And so when we got born again, we've been trained by the world so long, we never switch our eyes back a lot of times. So we try and fix things on this level, which would never fix it. You had to go to that level and do it. All right. Just think about what I'm saying here, because this the enemy. He cannot create. You can. Death and life is in the power of what? Tongue. Your tongue. My tongue. Why you think Satan needs you for the mouthpiece? He used people for their mouth because he's done. He had to use people for having. But that's why, and Jesus said, whatsoever you shall bind on earth. Wait. What is he saying here? Shall also be bound where? In heaven. That's Matthew 18, I believe, here. Watch this. 18:18. Whatever you shall bind on earth shall be bound where? In heaven. It's already bound. One version says it's already bound in heaven. Whatsoever you shall loose on earth is already loosed in heaven. It's waiting on us to operate within the framework of the word. God can't back anything outside the framework of his word. And to try and do it, you'll toil. You'll toil. Now watch this. So now, the realm of adjustment. Everything has to be adjusted from the unseen standpoint if you're going to change anything in the earth. Everything have a root to it that you can't see. Everything. Satan will try and touch something and contaminate it, and it will hide. You ever seen something in plain sight and you can't find it? Yes. But it's there, isn't it?
Yes.
And that's how the enemy do. He'll try and hide something in plain sight, and it take you to go up higher to see it sometime, because he'll disguise things. That's how confusion gets started. He disguised information and give information to one person, a piece of it, and give information to another person, another piece of it. Both of them are voided of all the information, so they get into it. And when they get into it, they're releasing words. And they think it's that person. And that person think it's that person. And they blaming that person. And they don't even like their boss. And they don't like that person. They blame the neighbor. And the problem ain't none of it.
Come on, Pastor.
That's not even the root. To get out of confusion, you have to rise higher than it.
Amen.
Confusion is at the level of the seen. That's why it's at walk in the spirit. Why? Walk in the spirit, you're going to walk above that. That's the unseen. Now, that's... So now, let's just say... The seen realm is a report card. It's actually a report card of what you actually believe about the unseen.
Wow.
So let's say a person is always in shortage. Believer, that is. Shouldn't be, but they are. Manifestation of that is just a report card of what they really believe about the unseen. Oh boy. I don't care how many jobs they can have 5 jobs and just be in shortage. Have nothing to do with how many paychecks. Everything is tied to what they can't see. There's an error in their thinking regarding the unseen, or something they don't see. I'm talking about a believer now, dealing with it. They avoid of some light. So they hear God say you the head and not the tail, but for some reason they getting an F in that, because they ain't producing that. They hear that my God shall supply all my needs, but I hear it, but my grade ain't producing what I'm hearing. They hear that they supposed to be rising in promotion, rising this, but for some reason, the grade ain't producing that. It have nothing to do with whether your boss like you. It have nothing to do with how many jobs you got. It have nothing to do with that. It have everything to do with there's some light missing. Unseen. I mean light, revelation. Because revelation always get you ahead and get you above. There's something missing in their spirit that they don't have understanding of. Amen. They haven't meditated that word to get down in them. So first thing, you know, one of the things, anytime I'm going from one level in something, whether, you know, we're buying this property or whatever, I didn't just wake up and say, I did it when I first started passing, but I couldn't handle that. Because sometimes God will hold things back from you because it'll crush you if you try and get it. Your spirit don't have the capacity for it, to hold it, Satan will steal it. And so when that thing came open, what happened? I started working on my spirit, man. I started putting more word, increasing the word on something. I would listen to a particular CD my dad had gave me listening to, and I listened to that thing over and over. I'm listening to it, and I'm getting revelation out of it. What you think is going on? Heaven is transferring something from the unseen. I cannot tell you there was a feeling when the guy called and said, do you still want to buy the property? Yes, I do. I didn't have no feeling. It's just that I knew it was already mine at that time. Amen. Because until whoever has the spiritual title deed is the real owner anyway. I owned the property before I closed on it. Amen. Okay. Oh, Lord, let me. Ephesians 1 and 3. Blessed be the God and the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all, what? Spiritual blessing in the heavenly place. Wait now. They are first, what? Spiritual. Didn't I tell you? They're unseen, but they're there. The real realm of creation, of reality, unseen realm, everything is already there. This realm here is the realm of manifestation. That's the only reality it for. Everything that you see will birth through what you couldn't see. So now let's look at this. People think a lot of time, well, money is my problem. Money is not your problem. Money is not your problem. Faith in the unseen is the issue. Faith in sin is already done. It's already done. Amen. You don't have to work for something that's already done. Amen. when they built my house, I only had to move in it. It was already done. Amen. I didn't have to go get the hammer. It was already done. Amen. Okay, let me. I'm gonna get you there. I know. Because your intellect trying to grab hold, can't do it. Y'all there? Y'all with me? Yeah. Okay, I just want to make sure. when you come into the kingdom, you have two routes. You had to choose out of one or two routes. You can choose to walk the way of the natural man. That's like shadow boxing, you know. Yeah. The natural man. So you look at your shadow, you're boxing. Are you hitting somebody? Nah. Mm-mm. You're just wasting energy. And shadow boxing, you can choose shadow boxing by guessing your way through life, using logic and intellect, which have a high margin of error, just to let you know, because you're dealing with a realm that connects to the spirit. And anything that you try and do in the natural that is out of alignment with the spirit don't answer. Amen. So there's limitation to your life when you choose to walk the natural man route, okay? Because you approach life sensually in your senses, in your emotions. Or then the second one, you can choose to walk the way of the spiritual man. And there are two ways you can measure to see if you walking as a spiritual person. The first one is your degree of submission to the supremacy of the Word of God. Nothing you live is the only influencer in your life. No opinions can make you change. You allow the Word to guide you in every step of life. All right? Everything you do, not opinion, because opinions mean nothing in the kingdom. It have no power. The flesh profit nothing. All right? The flesh profit nothing. Well, I heard what Pastor said, but I think that's why you'll stay at a level where you'll never see another level of light, because you're thinking. I think, and I'm not saying your mind is not there for your thing. Yeah, you got common sense, but I'm talking about spiritual things now, right? Spiritual things. Your opinion absolutely have no authority in the kingdom. So, first part of that, your degree of submission to the supremacy of the Word of God. This is how a person can tell they're spiritual now. Now, a lot of people don't like that because the way the enemy would attack you by you allowing the Word to be your main influencer, they'll call you religious. That's an attack of the enemy. Because I don't do this because of the Word, because I come to church, because, you know, what the Word said, because I don't, you know, you slipping and dipping and tipping, and I don't do it, and you call it because I'm saying, hey, that's, hey, let's go to the Word. You trying to be religious. That's an attack. And now that's something you don't never have to apologize with people for now, okay? I'm not telling people to go out and start being a Pharisee. I'm not doing that. But what I'm saying is that the word is my guidance. Show glory to God. I just saw something. The Word is my only guidance and my influencer, okay? Now, if a person feel bad because I'm walking it out and they allow the enemy to call me religious, or, you know, you just holier than thou, which they don't understand what that means. A lot of people don't really. It's in Isaiah. They talk about that. And so, you know, holiness really is your conduct. If you knew what that means, you know. And so now just think about this. So that Word, when it's your chief influencer, anything outside of the framework of that, you won't step into. So that's one of the ways of the spiritual man. The other one is the degree on how you brought yourself under the leadership of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That is how people can see that person walking as a spiritual man.
Hallelujah.
How they brought themselves under the leadership of the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. You have to choose to do those things. If those two things are not there, that person is not walking as a spiritual person. I am not saying that God don't love them, but I'm telling you, it have to be there. And I'm not talking about the point where I made a mistake. Well, it ain't got nothing to do with it. You make a mistake, you know you can repent and get right on the path. And the problem is when you don't repent.
Amen.
That's letting me know you ain't spiritual. You don't run around and let that heart got hard.
Amen.
How your heart is pliable, you're like, man, I messed up. I need to repent. That's under the guidance of the Holy Ghost, leading you to repent, to put you right back in the place where you need to be spiritually. No condemnation is involved with that.
Amen.
All right? When a person don't and then keep doing never and get bitter about it, they're not spiritual. And they can never rise high into a level of light that they can walk in dominion, making the seen realm submissive to them. Okay? To rise to the level where the seen realm submits to you, You're going to have to trust what you can't see in the natural with the word. Okay, Romans 4:17, put it up. As it is written, I made you a father of men and nations before him, whom he believed, even God who quickened the dead and called it those things what? Which be not. And so put that in the Amplified. Real quick. Look at this. As it is written, I made you the father of men and nations. He was appointed our father in the sight of God in whom he believed, who give life to the dead and speak of the non-existent things that have not manifested in our mind, has foretold and promised as if they already exist, as they already have manifested. Right. Two realms here. Two realms. Hebrews 11 and 3 in the TPT. Put it back up. I want you to see this. If you want to see something move in your life, you want to deal from it from another realm. You want to see your house in alignment with heaven, you want to deal with it from the realm that you can't see with the word. Faith empowers us to what? See. This is key here. This is key. Faith empowers us to see what, though? The unseen. The unseen realm. You ever had what they call deja vu? Yes. It flashed and it happened. Amen. And it seemed like you saw it before it happened, but you saw it, and when it happened, you say, it seemed like, for some reason, I can't remember. I seemed like I seen that before. Amen. You did. Amen. It's a flashing in your spirit. Amen. You capture something from the unseen realm. You just didn't know how to put it together. And what happened, what drowns it out, you get your intellect back involved. Amen. That's how I know every dream you dream is not a dream. On, it's your spirit. Oh, Lord, I don't want to talk about this. Should I even talk about it? Faith empowers us to see that the universe was created and beautifully coordinated by the power of God's what? Words. He spoke, and the invisible realm gave what? Birth. Wait. The invisible realm gave birth to all that is what? That's manifestation. Seeing realm is manifestation realm. That's the realm. That's that reality. Of the seen realm is just manifestation. It only there. Whatever you speak, whatever you do, you pulling it from the unseen. You don't see it in the natural first. Just think about what I'm saying. You purchase something online. You don't see it in the natural first. You see a picture of it. You don't come to reality until it get to your house. You ain't checked to see if they had the inventory. You ain't physically go to the place. You don't even know if that place exists. No. You just got an address of where it's coming from. Yeah. Just think about it. You don't know. It say coming from New Hampshire. You don't know that. You ain't get on a plane and go there and see. That's somebody can be selling something from their garage or something. You don't know. You don't know. You never been there. Then it shows up. So was it real when it got there? Or was it real before it got there? Before it got there. You just believed it. And you trust the tracking number. You trust it so much, you checked it every day. Just think about it.
Yep. Sure did.
As a matter of fact, when you paid for it, you called it yours. You ain't never touched it. Lord Jesus. I can't wait till I get my shoes. You ain't touched it. You don't even know the shoes been made. You just read what Amazon put on there. Whoever you shop with. Now, if you can trust them, Jesus. This book full of tracking numbers. Oh, good God from on high. I'm telling you, this book is full of tracking numbers. My God shall supply. It's full of tracking numbers. You find yourself short in the natural, my God shall supply all my needs. You find yourself sick. I'm telling you, he said, Jesus, he said, he took your sickness. Yeah. Glory to God. Yeah. Now, I'm telling you now, this is key here. He said, I made you the lender and not the borrower. Glory to God. You have to put your faith on the line with the word. Glory to God. And once you do that, you watch and see. You watch and see. She just received somebody's spirit, too. Yeah. Now, I'm showing you this, folks. Because faith empowers you to see. That is why Satan is after your mind. That's why he's after your imagination. That's why he'll put things in your imagination that your kid's going to get sick. Or you're going to lose this or that. Because he know that if your mind get renewed with the word, you'll get a snapshot. Glory to God. You'll get a snapshot of that which is already yours. Faith empower us to see that the universe was created and coordinated by the powerful words of God. He spoke and the invisible realm gave birth. I'm telling you, somebody gonna give birth to some of their dreams this weekend. You watch and see. Stuff you've been believing for, all of a sudden it's just gonna start opening up. You watch and see. Glory to God. The problem is never flesh and blood. Never. The more revelation you get, the more light you get, the higher you arise. And you can only rise to the degree of the light you get. But you have to make God's word absolute supremacy over your life. You know why? To kill all the plan Bs. Ain't no plan B. Got to kill it. Stop apologizing for growing spiritually. Stop. Stop apologizing. Don't do it. Don't do that. Don't do that. Just live it out loud. You're letting everybody else live out loud.
Come on, Pastor.
Me men wearing wigs and dressing and dancing in front of kids at a library. And TV broadcast that with the news like it's okay. Amen. Now, why is it okay for them to live out loud?
Come on, Pastor.
And the church hide.
Amen.
Probably the reason why a lot of places ain't seen the power. Amen. They're ashamed of the gospel. Amen. See, what you're ashamed of, you can't uplift. Amen. Now, I'm going to tell you something. If you don't watch it, Can I say this?
Yes, sir.
If you don't watch it, the enemy is threatened by your growth. He'll use people you know. I'm telling you. He'll use people you know to say stuff, whether on the job, off the job, whatever. You got to come to a place where you're straight up a gangster. Just say, I'm from the east side of heaven. I'm from the east side of the kingdom. My gang sign is the cross. I'm talking about just straight up. Everywhere I walk, I'm slaying demons. I ain't afraid of the terror by night. Glory to God. If you go to Psalm 91, that's a straight up gangster. Watch this. Let me show you something. Psalm 91 is straight up gangster. I'm telling you. He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Keep going. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God. In Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noise of the pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Yeah. Keep going. You shall not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walk in the darkness, nor for the destruction that wastes in the noonday. 1,000 shall fall at your side. Look at this. That means you got unseen angels that's destroying things. You walking through it. Look at that. 10,000 at your right hand. But it shall not come nigh who? Me? Verse 8. Only with your eyes shall you behold and see the reward of the wicked. While you're trying to knock me down, I will see your reward for trying to do it. Because you have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angel charge over thee and keep you in all your ways. That's what I'm telling you right there. Why shall you be just be a gangster? You just got to, like, I'm going to pray in the Holy Ghost. I'm talking just be a gangster about it. Just don't even worry. Don't even get out of your mind. Glory to God. Sometimes if you're not aggressive enough in the unseen, the enemy will try to subdue you. Go back to verse 9. No, go to 7, then 8, then 9. I want you to see this. 1,000 shall fall at your side. Go to verse 8. Keep going. Keep going. He said, I'm going to give, He shall give His angels, that's with an S, folks, charge over you. So if angels are with you,
yes,
you a game.
Amen.
You got a game with you.
Amen.
Think about what I'm saying here. Now, if Psalms 103:20, I pray this all the time. Bless the Lord, yea, His angels that excel in strength, that do His commandment and hearken to the voice of what? His word. Now, if that's the case, hearken to the voice of His word. If that's the case, Isaiah 51:16. I have put my words in your what? In my mouth, your mouth. So the angels are going to hearken to what we say in the word, folks. Every morning what I do when I'm praying, I say, okay, one thing I'm praying, Lord, people at City Faith Christian Center, members and visitors, when they're going to work, I release angels to go before them and prepare the way, clear the way. And if they need to go another direction, usher them. No hurt, harm, danger, or accident will come near them. Now, I'm done after that because the angels have took over. I'm telling you, you a gangster in the spirit. I'm telling you now. I'm telling you. Yeah. Stand to your feet. I really got some more stuff, but I can't get all this. I got, but I gave you what you're supposed to have, so. Amen. You ever wonder in Matthew 15:30? Watch this. And a great multitude came unto him, having them, those that were lame, blind, dumb, and maimed. Maimed is somebody who missing an arm or a leg or something. And many of it cast them down at Jesus' feet, and he healed them. It wasn't even hard. They was believing everything. Them body parts were growing back. They were just growing out. Because if they cut off the arm in the natural, don't mean in the spirit the arm is cut off, folks. You can't cut that spirit off. Think about it. Once he believed that, or she or whoever, that thing grew back. I seen this some years ago. This guy was wearing, his leg was, one of them was longer than the other, by like this. That's how long it was. And the pastor said, "You want to be healed?" He set the man in a chair. I seen it. And he commanded that leg to grow, to even out. I seen that man's leg. People start hollering. It grew out. Grew out. And that same me, it was a man that was in Vietnam who had lost an arm. And he was in the balcony. And the anointing was dropping into place because the people's belief was up there, right? And the pastor said, now this is the pastor talking. They were teaching on something and someone started screaming in the balcony. And he said, he went to see, hey, what's going on? The man's arm grew back in plain sight. Oh, come on, folks. What do John 14:10 say? The words I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that in me, he doeth the work. But I want you to see it, verse 12, though. He that believe on me, the works that I do, shall he do also, and greater what?
Greater works.
Well, this ain't just talking about the pastor. I'm talking about somebody coming on your job that you on your, I call your job your assignment. You on your assignment. Mm-hmm. And you speak a word to them in healing right then.
Manifest.
This is what I'm talking about. We got to stop politicking this low level. Well, she said this to me, he said this to me. Who cares? Your ego rise higher than that. Don't be in the chicken coop. Chicken's only good for frying. I want some wings right now. Father, we thank you for the word. Let me get out of here. I really want you to think about that unseen realm.
Yes, sir.
Don't ever become a slave to the seen realm. It'll limit your life. It'll limit you. There are times I have started off, I got the step from God to go to step A. I didn't get step B. So I stayed at step A. Then when I got to step A, step B lit up. I had to learn this stuff along the way. And I'm telling you, every step of the way, from anything me and my wife have done or whatever, it had to just be by faith. I tell you, I didn't struggle with that. I didn't. You know, when God do something for us and I hear the stories of other people, you know, even my community, I hear stories of other people, I'm like, man, I ain't struggle with that. Nope. I just, you know, and I'm not going to apologize for it. I pray with you that you don't struggle no more, but I'm not. This is key here. That's why Paul talks about your conversation. That your conversation, it had to be at a certain level sometimes. You know, when you're believing for something, whether the money or something, well, you don't need to be around someone talking about poverty. Amen. What? Amen. That's the setup from the devil. I'm talking to me about poverty. That's a bag of black snakes. I ain't gonna accept that. You know, you have to use wisdom. You have to use wisdom when doing this. Father, we just thank you. We thank you for the word. Oh Lord, we just Sunday. We know the patterns that you will show us on how to make changes in the unseen realm, to make the adjustments from the unseen to the seen so the seen can change. You know, you're not the same person you was 3 months ago, a lot of you. See, I was seeing how God did this. He said, you can teach on this until you dealt with love. You know, I began to see this. Because love is the force that causes this stuff to work. And I'm telling you, you're not the same as you was 6 months ago. Don't apologize. See, you rising to the top. As you rising, a lot of things gonna fall off your radar anyway. It's not even gonna be important. Because you going somewhere. And you watching me online, same for you, going somewhere. Oh man, I can see limitations broken. I can see it. I think the problem is we've been trying to change things in the seen realm with man's solutions and not with God's wisdom. And I think it's time to go up another level. If there's limitation in your life in the natural, there's something missing in that unseen realm that you need to get revelation of. That's all it is. It ain't something that you, I did it wrong. Get your mind off of that. That's some light that's voided. And what you have to do is get some of them CDs and listen. And maybe, you know, I get a little too extreme with some of it. I get one of my dad and I hear something. I get one of the tracks. I take that one track and I'll just put it on repeat and see. People think that girl, I'm telling you, but what happened, that thing get in me. This is how you do it. This is how you do it. You had to get aggressive with it. Until that thing is in me, I'm telling you, I wake up preaching it. Waking up quoting it. So, Father, we just thank you for the word. And Father, we thank you even in advance for Sunday. There will be a realignment. Sunday. It will be a realignment. We bind the hand of the enemy that will try and bring confusion. Because I'm going to tell you by tomorrow, see, the enemy don't like this part. Tomorrow he'll try to get you in some type of confusion. Walk away from it. Amen. It's a trap. It's a trap. Just walk away from it. It's a trap. Because they're trying to keep you from getting what you're going to get Sunday. Father, we thank you for it and call it done in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Glory to God.